Are you ready, kids?
Aye, aye, Captain!
I can't hear you!
Aye, aye, Captain!
This is probably the most requested video on my channel. So yeah, let's get started. But first of all, just want to say this is not how you're supposed to do it. This is just how I do it. This is my style. I usually like to duplicate the render in case I have made some mistake and just turn that off. Let's just go to filter, oil paint, the stylization to 10, the cleanness to 10, the scale to 10, and the bristles to 0. This is just how I like it. And the shine to 0. Then click OK. Then I want to duplicate that layer again, that unactive layer, then I just put it on the bottom of the oil paint. Then I create a layer mask. Then I grab myself a brush, then turn it to black, and I start erasing the something that I don't want to. Right, and after that we can go ahead and duplicate the original layer again, then put it on top, then go to filter gallery again. Then I like to give it a bas relief, but first we need to make it absolutely black, and you want to put the white at the bottom and the black at the top. Then you can copy these settings. The detail is 14, the smoothness is 3, and the light is from the bottom. Then you can click OK. Then you wanna change that layer to overlay, then set the opacity to 50, then make a layer mask again. Then in the layer mask you click Ctrl I and grab yourself a white brush. Then you wanna apply it to where you want it to. Alright, and then you wanted to copy the original layer once again and put it on top. Then to go to filter gallery, then you uncheck the bas relief and add new effect called glowing edges. And this is my settings. The edge width is 2, the edge brightness is 6, and the smoothness to 5. Then you want to change the layer style to linear dodge add and add layer mask once again, then click Ctrl I. Then on the layer mask, go grab yourself a white brush, then start applying it to place how you want to. And then after that, I want to merge all the layers. You can block this by holding shift, then right click it, then click first Ctrl J, and then you can click Ctrl U and set the lightness to 0, set the opacity to I think 75 is better. Then you can add a layer mask, grab a black brush. So the key is to Minecraft renders that you need enough light source. I think I'm going to change the color of this shite, and what I wanna do is click this hue and saturation, then I click create a clipping mask so it only applies to the layer below it. Then I want to change the hue. I think red is better. And after that, you can click the layer mask of the hue, then you can click Ctrl I. I want to make a gradient out of the shade. Then you can just select this. Let's just grab the lasso. And you wanna do that so you don't accidentally apply it to the shoes. Then I wanna make my brush a little bigger. This is just a stock brush that you can get with default Photoshop. You can see it has a gradient effect, and you wanna do that to the others. Now you can still change the hue to whatever you like. I think I'm just going to change it to cyan. Then I want to apply it. You can just click merge layers, and what I like to do to the blade is you can grab yourself a hard round brush, then you can just name it glow or reflect or something that you like, and click a new layer. You wanna grab yourself a hard brush, then maybe lower the size a bit and change the color to white. You want to make the glow, the first one is the big one, you click your first point, then you hold shift, then you click your second point, and then for the second one, then just lower your size a bit and just do this. Then you wanna make it to overlay. Then I like to delete this with a soft brush, and then I grab myself my own particle brush. I'll link it in the description. Then just sprinkle your particle there. Then it will create that effect, that glassy effect. And then for the glow, I like to grab a pencil, then just cut this out. Then after you're done, you can right click and click make selection. Then you can click Ctrl J and then go put it on top, and then select a change the layer style to linear dodge add. Then click to filter blur, Gaussian blur, and then you can put it to whatever you want. I think 15 is best. Just going to make the eyes black real quick. And for your line glow, then you want to click Alt while holding the brush, and you want to turn the brush size to 5. Then we can start applying the line glows. And then after that, it's time for the lighting. Then you wanna make yourself a new folder and create new layer. Then I usually use the soft round brush for lighting. Start adding the lighting, and how I do it is I grab myself a pencil, then just selecting out the limits of what I want to give it a brush. Okay, then you can click make selection, then you can click OK, then select your color and make this soft round brush a little big. And you can just start applying. If you're lacking of light source, you can just add one with a brush. Then I think I'll change the background to a night background, because a night background is usually good with glows. And these are the pupils. I got it from the Bump Back V2. Yeah, these are my color corrections. I'll make the render a little bit darker, but not also too bright. I think it's 55 is best brightness. Okay, I think that is all for today. I'll see you in my next video.
I love you.